at the press site.
That announcement from the public affairs people at NASA, there's a shot of the people who are here to see the launch, or landing. In some cases, family members, we think they're gone already, and many Kennedy Space Center workers, top officials of NASA are probably among that crowd, viewers, people who come here to, you know, always to cheer the landing and to see the space shuttle come home. And this is the 113th mission, 111 times the space shuttle has come home with no problem, and everyone's cheered and been happy. You had Challenger back in 1986 that did not return, and now you have STS-107 that has not returned. 8 minutes ago, it was supposed to come down on this runway, and it's not here, and it's not going to be here. Where it is, Mission Control tells us it was last known to be over Central Texas. That's about all we can tell you. Why anything, what could happen at that altitude, why anything could happen at that altitude is just absolutely unknown. You know, we know of a what was considered to be a minor problem before landing that they'll have to look into now. And what that was that during launch, a piece of insulation on the shuttle's big external fuel tank apparently came loose and struck the left wing of Columbia. Now, this was 16 days ago at launch. Now, through analysis and through some, whatever procedures they have, but not by direct looking, mission managers figured that the damage to the wing was very small. And as far as we know, they were right. I have no idea. They do not have a robot arm on the space shuttle on this flight. Did not have one. Don't have any way to stick a camera over the edge to see the wing. You really can't see the wing from the cockpit. Let's listen to this.
Securing information and data. The last communications with the Space Shuttle Columbia were at 8 a.m. Central Time as it was flying 200,000 feet above Central Texas, en route to the Kennedy Space Center for a landing. No communications have been received with the spacecraft since. No tracking data of objects of any kind reported by the Merritt Island tracking site and its C-band radar when used to sweep the sky. Flight Director Leroy Kane has declared a contingency. Flight controllers are securing all information and data and notes. No tracking reported again up Columbia since about 8 a.m. Central Time as it was descending toward Florida, toward the Kennedy Space Center above Central Texas.
Attention at the press mound. Again, I say, please shut down your operations and go to the press site.
Well, we could potentially be thrown out of here, but we'll wait around until they kind of pick us up and carry us away. It's a possibility, though. Well, you heard the latest report from Mission Control. The speaker just there was James Hartsfield, the NASA commentator who was in Mission Control. Just repeating the information that nothing has been heard from the crew of Columbia. They were supposed to land 11 minutes ago, and they are not here, and they are not coming back. They're not coming back to the Kennedy Space Center in one piece as far as the space shuttle is concerned. Whether or not they may have been able to come down someplace else, made an emergency landing is doubtful. It's very doubtful, but, we'll just hold out hope and wait to get the official word. Now, I was talking about the minor damage, what was considered to be minor damage to the wing. You know, it's a possibility. This is what could have happened. I was saying that they had no way of seeing that damage to the wing. And what they were doing was kind of extrapolating, trying to figure out, through analysis that, a piece of foam insulation, it's like styrofoam, the stuff that covers the tank, the orange that gives the tank its orange color. It's like big, thick styrofoam. If some of that comes off, through all of their analysis, they thought that there's no way that could do serious damage to anything on the space shuttle if a piece of that came off. And they can't really go recover it and go look at what it was. You know, obviously it's in the tiniest pieces. The tank itself breaks up and falls into the ocean after launch. There's no way to recover any of that to analyze that. It burns up on the way down. So you have damage to the wing of the space shuttle that we know. We have the flight director. In fact, I'm going to have our cameraman, Rick, go down and get that tape from yesterday. We'll lock down the camera. We'll get that press conference from yesterday, and we'll use both responses from Leroy Kane. We'll make an effort here to replay that for you have you hear the flight director, who is in mission control right now, brief the news media yesterday. This will take us a minute or two to get this rounded up here. When we get to it, we'll let you hear Leroy Kane himself explain what the situation was with potential damage to the space shuttle's wing. Now, all right, we may be being made to leave here, but let's see what we can do. Let me just finish that thought. When you have the damage to the tile, this is what keeps the space shuttle from burning up. When you have if the tile is missing, you could begin to have the aluminum frame of the space shuttle and wing. That could actually burn through and melt through at the temperatures that they experience during reentry into the atmosphere. So if the tile is not protecting the space shuttle, then you could begin to burn up, break up, you know, and if the wing gives way, then obviously they're not going to make it home. Now, I want to emphasize that I have no idea, I don't think anyone else has any idea at this point if that's what happened. We simply know at this point, yesterday Mission Control was telling us that there was some minor damage to the protective system to the tile on the wing. Let's listen to Mission Control now.
Teams have been mobilized to the Dallas-Fort Worth area. No tracking data or communications has been reported from the Space Shuttle Columbia since 8 a.m. Central Time this morning, as it flew 200,000 feet above North Central Texas en route to a landing at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Contingency procedures and mission control have a flight controller securing all information and data. From today's shuttle descent.
About 15 minutes now since anything was, or since the space shuttle should have landed. About a half an hour since anything was heard from the space shuttle at all. Seven crew members, Rick Husband, the commander, Willie McCool, the pilot, Mike Anderson, payload commander, Kalpna Chawla, mission specialist, Laurel Clark, mission specialist, Elon Ramon, Israel's first astronaut, all on board. We're still talking about NASA forcing me to leave from my broadcast position here, and if they do that, we'll go away for a little while and we'll come back. Let's go ahead and now listen to Leroy McCain from yesterday. I think we've got two responses that he had in a row, where he talked about the what he considered minor damage to the space shuttle's wing. Here's Leroy Kane.
We have plenty of margin in those areas in that regard, and that the impact could not have been from this particular material significant enough to take out any significant amount of tile. So I can't tell you inches by inches or depth, but I can tell you we think it's going to be very small.
Let's keep going, keep rolling.
Our final flight day highlights package will air on NASA television.
All right, well, we got part of it, that he considered it to be very small damage, and that just you know, didn't think there was any possibility that the minor damage to the space shuttle's wing could have caused any problem on the way down. But they had a problem on the way down. In fact, they never made it down. Seven people on the space shuttle. There's no reports from mission control, as you've heard, that that they landed anywhere else. And they can't still be up there. That's not possible. It's not possible for them to still be up there. So they didn't make it. And you heard also, I believe, that the seven there are recovery teams in the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
This is Mission Control Houston. Flight controllers here continue
begin some searching.
In a contingency securing information
again.
And data from today's space shuttle descent of the shuttle Columbia. Columbia's last communication was received at about 8 a.m. Central Time as Columbia flew 200,000 feet above North Central Texas. Search and rescue teams in the Dallas-Fort Worth area have been alerted. No communications or tracking of any type was received after 8 a.m. Central Time along Columbia's planned route toward the Kennedy Space Center, toward a landing there this morning that had been planned to take place at 8:16 a.m. Central Time.
All right, let's break away from James Hartsfield's voice here and give you a look at a video that is from Dallas, and that is hauntingly reminiscent of the Challenger disaster. That is something that is falling out of the sky, breaking up into pieces and burning near Dallas. Obviously made quite a significant sight in the air in Central Texas. We know that over Central Texas was the last moment that anything was heard from the space shuttle and crew. At no time have we been told that that there was any problem reported by the crew or that anything unusual was seen by Mission Control. Mission Control has not said, has not told us
last communications from the Space Shuttle Columbia
there was any problem
were above North Central Texas
reported
at 8 a.m.
by
Central
the space
time
shuttle
as it had descended
through
Florida.
Telemetry.
Any debris that is located in the Central Texas area or in that vicinity should be avoided and can be potentially hazardous, and its location should be reported to NASA. Again, flight controllers here in Mission Control have declared a contingency, securing all information and data pertinent to today's descent of the Space Shuttle Columbia.
All righty, we are being forced now to leave our broadcast position by NASA for some reason. Don't really understand why we need to do that, but we're going to need to go ahead and let the network take over. And as you look at what appears to be the debris from the space shuttle falling down over Central Texas, seven people aboard from that altitude, really no way for anyone to survive a fall. They have parachutes, they have all kinds of survival equipment, but that's not going to do you any good at 12,000 miles an hour. At 200,000 feet altitude, as you take a look at what may be the Space Shuttle Columbia, nobody confirming that, but you hear what Mission Control is saying, that debris over Central Texas should be avoided and reported to NASA. That's where they're looking, that's where they lost contact, and that appears to be what happened. So Dave Brown on the left here, didn't mention him before. Dave Brown, going left to right, Rick Husband, Laurel Clark, Kalpna Chawla, Mike Anderson, Willie McCool, Elon Ramon from Israel. Whether or not they will ever be heard from again has not officially been announced, whether they've survived or not, but don't think it's possible to survive what they've been through. And I'll be back with you in a few minutes. Raul?
Dan, thank you very much. Dan Bellew reporting there from Cape Canaveral. Obviously, what looks like it's another tragic day in the history of the space program. Obviously, everyone is very shaken up. We're going to join Network NBC program right now with the very latest.
Columbia is coming in many pieces, as it did here when Challenger blew up high over the launch pad. Look at all of these streaks of different pieces of this shuttle coming in. Did the same thing all over again.
Jay, let's re-examine the deorbiting process, because from what you told us, 8 minutes before the